In this illustration, we'll analyze the situation of a rod supported by strings. Here the figure shows a rod AB of length L and mass M supported by two strings which are of equal length and inextensible. And here we are required to find tension in one string just after other string is cut. So, in a situation we can analyze, when one string is cut, the situation would be like this. Say, this is the rod. And this is only in the support of the string at end B, and the string at end A is, say, snapped. So, due to this, what happens? The weight of rod will cause a rotational motion in rod, and a tension in the other string which is remaining is, say, T. Then we can write, if acceleration of center of mass of rod just after one string is cut is A, and angular acceleration is alpha, then here we use, we can write one equation as mg minus t is equals to ma, because center of mass is coming down with acceleration a, and if it is rotating at an angular acceleration alpha about and b, then the torque of tension about b is zero, only due to the torque of mg it will rotate. So we can write mg multiplied by l by 2 is equals to I alpha, which is ml square by 3, multiplied by its angular acceleration will be a upon l by 2 in this case, because the acceleration of center of mass we can write as l by 2 alpha. So, if this are equation 1 and this is equation 2, we can simplify the two equations, and here we can get from equation 2, here the value we are getting for A is 3g by 4. Now, from equation 1, we can write mg minus t is equals to m multiplied by 3g by 4. And simplifying this, giving us the value of t, that is mg minus 3mg by 4, that is equals to mg by 4, that is the result of this problem.